It's 7:15. We will be doing things in one moment. But I'm going to go ahead and have our social media lounge pull up the Twitch chat, but we will be doing a little bit of Q&A before we get to the meat of our pre-show. I'm really excited, as is everybody back here. We're switching to a new game engine. Promos are back. That's actually what we're doing right now, is we're working on the last promo of the night. But this is going to be a good time. We're really excited to be back. And this tonight is going to be full of twists and turns, a lot of new faces, a lot of redesigned faces, and we're going to have you meet everybody, meet the new crew of the MNWF in a little Royal Rumble that we're going to do in just a few moments here. Boring typing noises. This pre-show is pre-show excitement. Verify something real quick, and then we're going to get to our pre-show Royal Rumble, and we should still have enough time for predictions. So, if my broadcast colleague Roxy could come back over here to the broadcast booth. I think she's got to cut around that way, guys.
Okay. Okay, you can roll back to the side again if you want.
Okay.
All right, and it's still there. Yes. Good. All right. So, let's do ourselves up a Royal Rumble. We'll rumble ourselves royally here.
I royally rumble myself every night.
There was a lot of royal rumbling going on last night. Okie dokie. So, for those of you joining us for the first time, I'm sorry that I gave you a bad first impression by just, you know, typing a little bit and then getting into stuff, but I'm Trav Karan, and the MNWF, we are entering our fourth full season of action in 2017. Our first major season, though we've been around since 2007, if not longer. Our first major season of action came in 2011, where we actually did stories and tracked stats and did streams and stuff. We went on an extended hiatus. We did some stuff in 2012, some stuff in 2013 that was mostly private. We started the Twitch channel in 2015, and that was our second full season. We did a season from 2015 into early 2016, and then We had the 2016 season after another hiatus. And then we are starting the 2017 season. This is our fourth season as a Fed. Very exciting. Most people in this Fed are represented by real people. We've got a couple bots that are made of like really creative character ideas that we've come up with through the years. A lot of new stuff this time. A lot of new stuff this season. We've got, obviously, some major signings. We've got somebody from FSCW, our sister federation, run by Cobble S. Cobble. And we've got the other major signing that we've done is Anthony Falcone from Mega Championship Wrestling. He is joining us this season, and we're very excited to have him. So let's get started. As I'm going to show you the family picture, we're going to get started here with our Royal Rumble match here on the pre-show. Yes. Oh, this is the shot. This is in Columbus. All right. Let's mash go and get ready. This is from MMWF Fan Access, recorded yesterday. So that was yesterday at the Fisher Field House on the beautiful Ohio State campus. But we'll get started here with this 30-man Royal Rumble match. Yes. And of course, this is an exhibition Royal Rumble.
Yes, this is just an exhibition, no implications. This is all male superstars. We were able to secure this last-minute contract with the shot, but unfortunately, the individual able to get it would approve it only without male and female violence. So here we go.
Sounds good.
But this is, of course, the Royal Rumble match.
Mm-hmm.
3D individuals all drew numbers. They will come in sequential order about every 90 seconds. You can only be eliminated by being thrown over the top rope and your feet hitting the floor outside. The last individual in the ring wins the Royal Rumble.
Well, things getting started here. Wrestling excitement. And Brady Pope, number one entry into the Rumble here.
Our interstate champion, Brady Pope. One of the most storied competitors in the MMWF. Fantastic world champion. Making his entrance out as entrant number one to the Royal Rumble tonight.
Brady Pope, of course, spent most of the 2016 season as the man without a faction after Inferno Rising fell apart and became Punished Brady, ending his season, though, with that big, emphatic win over his rival Sentinel, taking the Interstate title. The bad news, of course, is that Sentinel has an ankle injury and will not be competing as of right now. Sentinel suffered an ankle injury during the offseason. We hope he has a speedy and full recovery. Second out to the ring is Dave Boston Springford, the current TV title holder, who has a high-profile fatal four-way match tonight defending that TV title.
Now, the TV title is not up for grabs or in any way in jeopardy in this Royal Rumble match. It will only be in a fatal four-way match over tonight, where he has absolutely no chance of defense soul spent a huge amount of time with the team and the team. He put his body and his life and his career on the line for the edge of midnight.
Boston, of course, that first Champions Cup winner. He had one of the most impressive seasons in 2016. He really deserved that TV title run. Let's hope that he can defend it again as we start the 2017 season.
Boston starting things off, and Boston starting off with a couple of strikes, but gets blocked, and Brady clotheslines him, and the 2017 season unofficially underway with this exhibition Royal Rumble match. It's going to be a real good way for us to get an introduction to both the new superstars and some of the new looks that we have in the 2017 season.
Brady fighting his way back into the ring here, taking some clubbed right hands on Boston. Freddy's wheel, the turnbuckle is down. comes in at entry number three. Oh, what a German from Brady.
Justin Downs is here, joining the action against Brady and Boston. Brady in the turnbuckle. Downs gets behind Boston, but Boston with a nice reversal. Big belly to belly there. Boston's belly a little bit bigger than Downs' belly, of course.
What an uppercut from Brady.
This is a real good way for these guys to get reacquainted, not just to the live wrestling environment, but to the crowd noise. The intangibles that you don't talk about. Like, people talk about strength and durability, but the crowd noise can get to you when you're in that ring.
Oh, Pope makes us to stay in with the double O. And Sarathun is in now.
Brady trying to win from number one here. Sarathun in at four. He did a very good job trying to win from the number one position in the actual Royal Rumble that happened back in July at Strike Resolution. Boston stays alive.
We get four individuals in this ring here. Sarathun coming out in a white tiger outfit.
There is a very diverse set of skills in this ring right now. Sarathun is almost like a video game boss. Brady is the man of a thousand pins. We've got Justin Downs, who's as wily as a cruiserweight, but he's put on some muscle weight, so he's a little bit tougher. And then we've got Boston, who may actually be certifiably insane.
Lee Downs weighed in before the Rumble at 235. And looking to put on another final muscles.
Brady's got Boston in the turnbuckle, and out comes Party Boy at five. We want to talk about diversity here. Well, Party Boy's coming out to the ring to add the cruiserweight element. Two-time cruiserweight champ. That's not a joke.
So you're looking to eliminate Downs here.
Not a favorable matchup for Downs by any means.
Oh, but Party Boy getting some key action in there.
Not the first time Party Boy has caught Brady by surprise from behind.
We call that.
Yeah, I did have a frame drop, but it's stabilized. 3, 2, 1.
Oh,
Brady
no.
is gone! Party Boy eliminates Brady!
Too much of that double team offense.
Yeah.
Brady's not going to win from one. He barely lasted five superstars as Jimmy Hotkeys comes out to the ring. And now we've got two cruiserweights in the ring. Jimmy Hotkeys, one half of our tag team champions, so we've got two title holders in the ring as well.
Sarathun going after Party Boy. I don't believe that's a very... Well, he managed to work his way out.
Asymmetrical warfare there, Roxy. Asymmetrical warfare.
Everybody in this ring
has held a title at least once in their careers. Of course, Sara Thune, the only world champion in this ring. But this is a pretty decorated crowd right here.
There goes Party Boy.
Sara Thune takes him out without much trouble at all. That was a big reversal by Downs. And now it looks like people are starting to team up on Sara Thune. Not a bad idea. As Sumo Scheiderman comes out to the ring.
Sara Thune's former colleagues with the masks now running independent after being kicked out
of DDST. Speaking of getting kicked out, Boston just got kicked out of the ring. And we've got Downs, Hotkeys, and Sara Thune in the ring right now. Sumo on his way over, keeping the big guy element. Sumo also a frequent flyer with the TV title.
Sumo here minding his own business, but Sara Thune maybe get snuck up on here by Sumo.
Sumo also got a, this is important to say, like, we talk about the new looks that everybody's sporting in this new season. Sumo got a full body wax. He's no longer with DEST, he's trying a new look, he's trying a new thing, he's, got no more body hair.
Got to shave?
He's shaved and waxed, as Downs is eliminated by Jimmy Hotkeys.
Hotkeys may be trying to get Sumo.
As one of the more mysterious new signings of this season coming out to the ring now, Pariah is here, and we know from our analysis during the hiatus and our announcements of the new signings, we don't really have much information about Pariah, his history, where he came from. We just know that he's from Columbus, Ohio. But we don't.
Pariah looking to eliminate Sara Thune.
This hometown crowd already ready to see him eliminate one of the biggest threats to the health of the MMWF in 2016. As he tries again, he threw Sara Thune over the top rope, but Sara Thune able to recover.
Taking a big shot from Pariah.
2-1, and Hotkeys is gone. Sumo eliminates Hotkeys. This is becoming a real revolving door of talent. Doesn't really seem like people can stay in for more than 4 superstars, but look at Mamba Negra! Mamba and Sumo also once teammates. We have 3 former members of the Masks in this ring right now. But these guys are absolutely not on the same page anymore.
Quiet hangs on there. From Sara Thune.
Sumo whips Mamba between Pariah and Sara Thune, and they're able to get some separation. 9, 8, 7. The countdown begins for our next superstar.
I'll be here trying to chop down Sumo.
And it's Gio Cavalcanti who is returning for the 2017 season. He was doing a little bit of part-time work in FSCW. He had an impressive showing in the tournament that they just had, but he's back here to do full-time work for the MMWF. And now we've got 5 superstars. Once again, a great variety of styles here. If you discount the fact that we really don't know what Pariah's style is yet. But Gio's going to get started with that hybrid of brawling and technical wrestling. He's going to try and toss Mamba out of the ring here.
Pariah hangs on one more time.
Sara Thune gets a chance to pose for the crowd. An impressive, impressive backside suplex by Pariah. And here comes Peter O'E, who is returning from a concussion. He had a major concussion at the hands of our current world champion, Brandon Fuzzy Harper, but he is cleared to return, and he is back for this season, wrestling for that TV title later tonight.
Sumo and Sara Thune tuned up. Sara Thune hanging on one more time. These two know each other very well. It's Oh, he's putting in some serious work here. Phenomenal.
OE, yep, trying to eliminate Mamba here. Sara threw it in the corner. Gio's got Pariah turned up. We've got six superstars in the ring right now. Sumo and Sara Thune almost look like they're sparring at the wrong corner. Mamba's gone. Crowd not happy about that. The returning OE eliminating Mamba Negra.
Oh, what a German that Gio. I don't know a lot about Pariah, but he is certainly one of the bigger individuals, not only in the Federation, but in this ring, certainly as well.
Gio tossed over the top rope, but OE getting right in on Pariah here. Reversed on by Gio.
Sumo barely hanging on there.
And that is a lot of strength to be able to hold up his body weight. He clocked into what, 440?
Oh, yes. He is absolutely super heavyweight. I believe by weight, he may be the biggest superstar in the Federation. Sumo actually saved Sarfu from a brutal headbutt.
Gio trying to toss OE. These two not... They definitely had their share of scuffles in the previous season in the lower and mid-card. But now OE might be gone. Welcome back to the Fed, OE. As Kudo Ryu, the first representative of what is now DEST, come out to the ring, and OE hangs on. Look at that. Impressive. Sarathun asking for a timeout after that elimination. And I think that OE is not going to stick around this time, as Gio, working on eliminating him again. Sure enough, out he goes, and Sumo tosses Kudo, the only cruiserweight in this ring right now. Gio and Kudo. The Marine versus the Yakuza here. And Sarathun and Sumo continue their little sparring match in the center of the ring. It's going to be very difficult for either of these guys to eliminate the other alone.
No, the harder they work on each other, the less each of them has any chance to win. Well, look at this.
Are you kidding me? Sarathun showing off the strength.
Triple deadlift powerbomb Sumo.
Kudo with a key stop gets back into the ring going after Gio here. Sumo, after eating the triple powerbomb, right back up, gets a big belly to belly. Kudo in a bad way here. The returning Sarathun working hard on Sumo, but he's had some difficulty with the big guy.
Man, it's a big guy challenge.
Yep, here comes the biggest of big guys, though. Ned is coming out to the ring. Ned's got a world title match later tonight to prepare for.
Sarathun's in dire straits here.
Oh! Sumo calling him out!
The crowd pops huge. Sumo able to eliminate Sarathun.
Yeah, you do.
Kudo getting worked on by Gio again, and now Ned's going to work on Sumo. These two definitely had their share of matches last season as well. As Kudo is gone.
Sumo teaming up on the fairly big but still much smaller than either of them, Gio Cavalcante. 6'4" man, 270 pounds, but looks like a cruiserweight compared to these individuals.
Gio tying up, and now Gio and Sumo are going to double team on Ned.
Oh my gosh.
As the other half of our tag team champions come out to the ring at number 14.
Oh, Ned's gone.
Ned eliminated by Sumo. Sumo is overpowering everybody. Cam's coming into the ring just in time. Huge crowd pop for Cameron, even as Ned gets eliminated. The hometown boy, one half of the Aces of Base, and immediately goes to work on Sumo. Cam with a nice springboard move there, runs into Gio there.
Oh, wow. What strength there by Cameron.
And now we're going to see double team Cam and Sumo on Gio,
as we wait for another entrant to come in. Coming in at number 15, marking the halfway point, is Richard Blues Lamar, which means that we're going to see Sonic versus Knuckles yet again. Richard, oh my gosh!
Very impressive back body drop by Gio. And Richard going for the throw here. Can literally.
Sumo managing to stay alive, but he gets bounced off the ropes. And Gio, what a German! Could Sumo be starting to run out of gas here? As sure enough, Cameron and Richard continue to tie up, and Sumo's gone! No. New York, Columbus, Columbus. As Joshua comes out. And this match just got a whole lot creepier. As Cameron hangs on from the double team, Joshua in the ring.
Joshua maneuvering around the cam.
Pro Wrestling Torch called Joshua one of their three people to watch in 2017. They think that Joshua is poised for a big run in this season. Cameron gets behind Joshua here, though, and he may not be around for long. Richard trying to eliminate Gio. Cameron trying to eliminate Joshua. We're almost down to just Sonic versus Knuckles, but Joshua getting back in the ring. Next up is our world champion, Brandon Fuzzy Harper, coming out at number 17.
Joshua.
Now once again, Sonic and Knuckles tangling. Gio going right after the world champ. Once again, two title holders in this ring right now. The crowd getting exactly what they paid for here at Fan Access. Gio in dire straits. Fuzzy trying to eliminate the Marine. Cameron was punch drunk. Joshua had a missed opportunity there. And Gio's gone! And here comes one of our special guests tonight. He's not on the MWF roster, but he is a very special guest of our executives tonight. Cole Morentet of the FSCW. He is in the building tonight, and he is in this Royal Rumble.
But look at Richard showing off there, right in front of Cole.
Cameron asking for a timeout as our two title holders duke it out on the near side of the ring here. Cole and Richard trying to eliminate Joshua. Cole, of course, just got second place in that big tournament in the FSCW Championship race. Lost to Corey Kerr, who is, of course, now a full-time talent with the MWF.
Sandwiching Richard there. Nice double team maneuver.
Cameron's gone!
Cameron eliminated by our world champion, Brandon Fuzzy Harper.
Fuzzy not really getting much love from the Columbus crowd for eliminating the Columbus original Cameron.
Cool going right after Joshua.
And, oh, you gotta be kidding me! What? Fuzzy calling him out! Fuzzy wants it! You gotta be kidding me! Chim Chim the Gorilla is here!
Oh,
Joshua's gone! And Cole waving to Chim Chim. He's ready too. This crowd, I don't think that they know what they're getting into. Chim Chim is ready to throw some gorilla hands here.
A 7'2" Chim Chim.
He's going to bench Harambe up in this ring tonight.
Chim Chim being billed from Cincinnati, Ohio. As Cole immediately ties up with his FSCW counterpart, Chim Chim. Richard trying to eliminate Fuzzy here.
said Rusev was trying to line up a dropkick, but just took too much time.
These two are vets. Vets of the MMWF. And they're sharing the ring with two relatively newer faces to the MMWF. Though they've both been around the pro wrestling block. Chim Chim has been with FSCW for a long time. Cole, a relatively younger guy with FSCW, but he's been professionally wrestling.
FSCW.
Oh, here we go! We've got Cole, we've got Corey, we've got Chim Chim, but we don't got Richard, because Richard was just eliminated by Fuzzy. And Corey immediately going after the world champ!
Corey's trying to make a point right here, right now.
Absolutely trying to make a statement here against our world champion, Corey Kerr, the FSCW world champion.
Champion versus champion, Corey making his in-ring debut, his official in-ring debut, on Wednesday night on Ignition.
Put a chair off the ropes.
Manhattan drop as Chim Chim put on the ropes here by Cole Marentet, trying to get the elimination.
Oh no! Fuzzy!
Paul, welcome to the Fed. Fuzzy proves he's the better world champion for right now anyway. And now Bjorn Ironsides is coming out to the ring next. Fuzzy now working on Cole Marentet. He's going to try and eliminate the winner and the second place person from that tournament. But Chim Chim getting the interference. And now Bjorn Ironsides. Cole not having any of it. Chim Chim's got Fuzzy on the ropes.
Cole going right after Bjorn.
Fuzzy on the apron yet again. Chim Chim trying to eliminate our world champ. Bjorn and Cole tying up. And that is the kind of matchup that I could get used to seeing. Cole Marentet versus Bjorn Ironsides. And Anthony Falcone, another one of the new faces to the MMWF, coming out to the ring next. And now we've got Anthony. Anthony, of course, had a match with the Kalahari Gorilla at ColossalCon last year, and Chim Chim is gone!
We won't have to deal with Chim Chim, this gorilla, tonight.
I was about to say, does that give him an advantage here?
Well, we've got Cole, we've got Anthony Falcone, we've got Fuzzy, we've got Bjorn Ironsides. Falcone on the ropes, Cole Marentet really showing up to work tonight. Who we got next? Number 23 is Minoru Akage, and he is definitely outclassed right now.
One here. Eliminated by Fuzzy.
Fuzzy with three eliminations on the night. And he's going to try and make it four. He's going to try and eliminate Minoru quickly. Oh, but the Tilt-A-Whirl backbreaker stopped in a Hurricane Rana.
I moved everything.
If you follow indie wrestling at all, Cole Marentet versus Anthony Falcone in that corner right now is almost a little bit of a dream match.
I'd say more than almost.
Oh no! And those two, as they're distracted, Fuzzy and Falcone are going to tie up. And Fuzzy is going to try to welcome another person to the MMWF. Tosses Falcone over the ropes, but Rohan! Out of nowhere! He's so pale, how can I not see him? He blends in with the ropes. Legitimately impressive showing from Rohan as he is the Maven to Fuzzy's Undertaker, and Fuzzy is immediately going to Undertaker his Maven, of course.
Ready the Maven?
Oh my god.
This drop there from Minoru.
Minoru now getting to work on Cole Marentet, and oh, a nice wheel kick, and the Cruiserweights trying to come back in this match. Counting down to entrant number 25. It's Razor Cuts, another Cruiserweight coming in. Oh, razor cuts. His challenge, he's got a cruiserweight exhibition match tonight with the cruiserweight champion, Trav Pahrane. That's happening later tonight. Match excitement, as now Razor's trying to eliminate Cole here, and that would really make him look pretty damn strong as he tries to eliminate Cole for Intep, and he doesn't! Oh, so close.
Yeah, we got a potato from the top.
Yeah, yeah. No, we just dropped a bunch of frames at once. Fuzzy. What a suplex there on Rohan.
Minoru
not quite eliminated by Cole Marente. And we've got six superstars in the ring, three cruiserweights, two special guests, new signings, and then our world champion, Fuzzy Harper, who is trying to eliminate Rohan right here.
Oh, what a real kick there. Anthony Falcone showing that experience in the ring.
And a stalling vertical facebuster from Minoru on Cole Marente, and Cole's going to make him pay for that.
Fantastic journey there from Anthony.
Minoru just doesn't have the strength to make that work. And Cole is going to try and eliminate the dragon here. And there he goes! Fuzzy in dire straits. Rohan looked like he might have the elimination.
Oh, wow, what a hurricane right there from Razor.
Yes. He calls that the Razor Rewind, and he hits it on Anthony Falcone, and now Cole's going to try and eliminate him.
Rohan.
Rohan's gone. That's four eliminations for Fuzzy. The world champ showing exactly why the cream rises to the top, proving Macho Man Randy Savage right now. He's going to try and eliminate Razor Cuts.
Anthony going after Cole here.
Cole up on the turnbuckle. Razor resisting as hard as he can.
Ooh, Razor's a stand.
The Jersey Devil going to work on the Canadian Bulldog. Cole Marente thrown into the ropes.
Oh my gosh, a dragon suplex. Cole could be out cold.
And Razor's gone! Five eliminations for Fuzzy. He cleans out all the cruiserweights. Who is next? Fuzzy's looking to get fed some more as he slowly turns around, and sure enough, it's another cruiserweight. Anthony Falcone is gone, and we've got Cole and Fuzzy in the ring, and the crowd is hot, red hot for this matchup, as Yoctor, though, gonna get a critical hit. Cole immediately trying to get rid of the trickster, aided by Fuzzy, who's going for 5.5 eliminations. Yoctor trying to gank in mid lane, but got caught in a team fight. Cole continuing to try and eliminate Yoctor with Fuzzy's help. Did they get him? No, as Eric the Cobra Grunt comes in, once again representing the cruiserweight division. But he is going to be outmatched here. Cole, Eric, Yupter, and Fuzzy. Again, a pretty diverse range of styles.
Fuzzy has used a lot, taking a lot of damage.
Yeah.
You have to put him out here.
What a huge upset that would have been. Cole's more of a traditional wrestling guy. Fuzzy is the hardcore superstar. Yupter is sneaky, he's tricky, he's good on defense. And then Eric the Cobra Grunt is really good with the microphone.
Here's Taco Loco.
Oh! Fuzzy hits the ring!
Hangs on!
Taco Loco, who moves like a cruiserweight. The Luchador
out in the ring as Yelter continuing to try and eliminate our world champion. Fuzzy's up against the ropes. Not a good look for the world champ as Yelter has hit him quite a few times in a row. He's gone!
Oh, and Yelter gets the elimination. But he turns around to Cole.
Eric just tried to eliminate Taco Loco there. Taco Loco tossing Eric over the top rope, trying to clean out.
And there goes Yelter.
Cole taking out Yelter, and now he's got Taco Loco on top of him.
We got Freak Show.
If I'm Eric the Cobra Grunt, I am very, very concerned about the next 10 minutes of my life.
Yes, absolutely. So 10 minutes, that's a very, very generous estimate. As Freak Show tosses him over the top rope, immediately grabs that helmet of his. As Cole Morentet trying to eliminate Taco Loco, not going to do it. Eric the Cobra Grunt somehow stays alive. And now Eric putting Freak Show over the top rope. And now we're going down to number 30, and we haven't seen one name all night, and it is the last title holder of the night. It is Cruiserweight Champion Trav Karan at 30.
Suplex there.
Belly to belly by Cole on Taco, and Trav Karan's just eyeing down this. He is not scared, but he goes right after Cole Morentet, who pummels him with that tilt-a-whirl backbreaker. Huge running lariat by Wooly as we're getting down to our final three here.
Oh, the dragon suplex from Shaw.
Trav with that big atomic drop. Jumping elbow, calling the shot. Karate moves on Cole. Trav Karan trying to show why he calls himself the most important man on the show, but he is about to get face busted there. As this has become a brawl for all here. Eric somehow still alive. Trav Karan sneaking up on Taco Loco, taking the opportunity, and there's a big neckbreaker with a knee. Eric getting a chance to catch his breath and refocus because he's still alive in this match.
You know how humans evolved to be humans? By being rats before, hiding in the corners while the dinosaurs went walking by, and that's Eric's strategy here. Literally, he's just lifting people up for other people to grapple right now. Except for right then.
Yeah, Wooly's done with that. Wooly's done with the sneakiness. He's ready to... Oh, wow, Cole, though, caught Wooly off guard.
But Eric screwed it up. He could have been part of that...
Could Trav Karan get eliminated here? He is not going to get eliminated. He hangs onto the top rope.
The dinosaurs just noticed the small furry creature and are swooping in.
Wooly has Eric down, but Cole is sent bullies up on Wooly, and Eric's still alive. Trav trying to eliminate Taco Loco here.
Cole is taking everybody out of this equation as fast as possible.
And Taco's gone! The Cruiserweight Championship
is gone!
Oh my god, our final three is Trav Karan, Cole Morentek, and Eric the Cobra Grunt. Eric was the last. He was in the final two in the FSCW Royal Rumble.
And remember, he was a previous holder of this Cruiserweight that out of nowhere stole it from Trav. He could pull an upset here again tonight.
Cole trying to eliminate.
I doubt it at this point.
Eric stays alive. Trav working on Cole. I think that he wants to eliminate Cole first because he knows that he can take Eric 8 days of the week. Trav Karan reversed on by Eric and Cole. Now they're going to, they might double team up on Trav, the Cruiserweight Champion. Eric, call.
They're continuing to call for timeouts.
Crowd pops huge. Trav takes it on the dome.
Eric, though, almost trying to keep the balance.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Can Eric and Trav double team up on Cole and eliminate him? Could this be it for Cole Marentet? The Canadian Bulldog trying to hang on. And he does. Eric in behind Trav here. Got him in that rear waist lock. Puts him over in the turnbuckle. Cole getting the crowd excited as Eric's got Trav up on the ropes. Eric could once again be in the final two of a rumble. Trav hangs on again. Cole came in and tried to finish the job, but he missed his strike. Eric once again putting Trav over the top rope. Trav survives again. And now Eric gonna get double teamed. Cole Marentet puts Trav over the top. Eric, now he's up against the ropes. Trav trying to eliminate him. Cole trying to get in there and make this a serious fight.
Cole grasping randomly in the air.
Eric's out.
Eric's gone, and our final two are Cole Marentet and Trav Caron. And Trav basically tells Cole to eliminate himself. The cruiserweight champ. It's the cruiserweight champ versus the FSCW star.
What's it gonna be?
The Canadian Bulldog ducks the grapple. Trav Caron entered at number 30. He's got Cole over the top rope. Cole gets back in. Trav with a key block on the strikes, but Cole reverses it. Puts Trav in the turnbuckle, and the special guest from the FSCW could be winning this rumble here.
Tying up again, Trav punching above his weight class here.
Trav has Cole in the turnbuckle.
Oh no!
Oh, he's gone! Trav wins from 30! The Cruiserweight champ of the MMWF gets the win! Exhibition Royal Rumble making everybody look real good. Some unexpected faces getting some huge, huge bursts of offense here. Fuzzy looking monumental, but it's Trav Caron, the Cruiserweight champ, that gets the win. That was a very, very good match. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we are getting ready to switch over to our main show. And we will be back shortly with Collateral Damage 2017 from Fan Access. Thanks, everybody, for tuning in. We will be right back here live on Twitch.